if the angel had come to him in the form of a man, they would have said, why don't you bring us an angel? They still wouldn't have understood. So anyway, so this that explains the fallacy of what they're asking. They ask, why don't you bring us an angel? And Allah clarifies another surah of the Quran. If even if an angel had come, they still would have rejected. أو يلقى إليه كنز أو تكون له جنة يأكل منها. Or why don't, or another sign? Or how about a treasure chest or his own secret garden or a miraculous kind of garden, a jannah that he can eat from, that's special to him, and some kind of miracle they're asking for. But if anyone who's read Seerah or read the biography of the Messenger of Allah, would know that whenever the mushrikeen asked for signs, be it Quraysh or previously, when they were given the sign, they still rejected. When they were given signs, they still rejected. One of the signs that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave them was the split of the moon. The moon split into two. And what was their response? Oh, Muhammad's done magic on our eyes. The one miracle which still remains up to today, which is what, anyone? The Qur'an. The Qur'an is a miracle. Allah has challenged mankind. If you truly doubt this Qur'an, bring something like it if you think it's your truth and your claim. But up until today, no one's been able to match the Qur'an. They've tried, but they've only failed, which more emphasizes the miraculous nature of the Qur'an. But the point is, even the miracle of the Qur'an, what did Mushrikeen say about the Qur'an? Oh, it's just shirk. Oh, it's just magic. Oh, it's just a kahana. Even when a miracle came, they tried to brush it off with fallacy. وقال الظالمون إن تتبعون إلا رجلا مسحورا. And those who are oppressors, they say, you're only just following a man who's done magic has been done to him. سحر مسحور sorry, someone magic has been done to him. انظر كيف ضربوا لك الأمثال فضلوا فلا يستطيعون سبيلا. Look, Allah said, look at how they try to bring similitude, try to bring these kind of accusations about you. And these things have only led them to more destruction. What they have said about the Quran. And Allah continues about the issue of praising Himself. تبارك الذي إن شاء جعل لك خيرا من ذلك جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار وجعل لك قصورا. And blessed be the one who, if he wanted, he would have given to you a lot better than what you have. As in, this is comparison, as in, don't be deceived, and don't follow the vain speech of these people. If Allah wants to, he will give you that which is better than what you have today, as in Allah is reminding them, look, there is something better than this world you have, this life you have. And Allah mentions Jannat, Jannah, paradise, that rivers flow underneath this paradise, as in, the nature of Jannah is something that no eye has ever seen, nor we even contemplate. And Allah will give you castles inside this paradise. بَلْ كَذَّبُوا بِالسَّاعَةِ. However, the kuffar, they disbelieve in the last hour. They disbelieve in the day of judgment. The day of judgment is a tenet of Islam. Whoever that disbelieves in the day of judgment, even if they believe in everything else, are not Muslim. Because there will be a day when everybody will be resurrected from their grave and will have to answer for their deeds that they used to do in this life. And the kuffar, they disbelieve in the sa'ah. وَاَعْتَدَنَا لِمَنْ كَذَّبَ بِالسَّاعَةِ سَعِيرًا. And Allah has prepared for those who disbelieve in the sa'ah, sa'ir, as in a hellfire. إِذَا رَأَتْهُم مِّن مَكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ سَمِعُوا لَهَا تَغَيُّضًا وَزَفِيرًا. And this part is amazing. That's why I encourage everyone who can have the ability to try and learn Arabic. When the kuffar, and this is not just the issue of listening to me, this is the issue of you imagining what I'm trying to say to you, what Allah is trying to say to you. When the kuffar will see the hellfire, they will hear it. And they will hear the sound of a sound which Allah mentioned, taghayyud, which is a sound of which it emphasizes like extreme anger. And the sound, if you can imagine someone's being choked to death, somebody's strangled, that sound that you have, that's one of the sounds that they will hear coming from hellfire. They haven't even gone there yet. They haven't entered into hellfire yet, but they will hear hellfire and now coming towards them. Imagine how they will feel. Imagine how we will feel when we're in Yawm al-Qiyamah. We know about what's going to happen, and we don't know what's going to happen to us. Will we be in the people of the hellfire or people of Jannah? Which is the emphasis on how we should use this month of Ramadan especially, as well as the rest of our lives, to make sure that we're not from the people of hellfire, min ashab al-sa'id. وَإِذَا أُلْقُوا مِنْهَا مَكَانًا ضَيِّقًا مُقَرَّنِينَ دَعَوْا هُنَالِكَ ثُبُورًا. And when they are thrown into this tightly restricted place, ضَيِّقًا, as in they will be restricted and not and confined. مقرنين, as in their hands will be shackled with chains to their necks. Thrown into hellfire, and there's further descriptions of hellfire. They will ask for destruction. Oh, just destroy us. They will say, just let us, we would prefer death than this. لا تدعوا اليوم ثبورا واحدا وادعوا ثبورا كثيرا. And Allah will say to them, don't just ask for destruction just once. Ask continuously, because it won't help you. Continue to ask for destruction, because you will never receive it. Hellfire, forever. Punishment, thrown in your face. Burning. Continuously, every time your skin is burnt off, you'll be given a new one so you can feel it. That's hellfire. And that's what Allah's promised for the disbelievers. قُلْ أَذَٰلِكَ خَيْرٌ أَمْ جَنَّةُ الْخُلْدِ الَّتِي وُعِدَ الْمُتَّقُونَ. And as is common with the Qur'an, contrast. Allah just mentioned hellfire in order to those who have a soft heart, to increase them in fear, to make them remember what's coming. But also Allah balances that with a reminder of what is in store for the believers. Allah says, say to them, what is better? That hellfire that's prepared for you, for the kuffar, or an everlasting paradise that has been promised to those who have taqwa, which is a state of iman, which prevents you, or state of which prevents you from sins. More taqwa you have, the more likely you're not to commit sins. كَانَتْ لَهُمْ جَزَاءٌ وَمَصِيرًا. This paradise will be a reward for them and a final destination. لَهُمْ فِيهَا مَا يَشَاءُونَ خَالِدِينَ. Inside this paradise will be whatever they want. What you want, the desires you can think of, eternally will be for you. Be for you. As in, you have lots of things you want in this life, and we get deceived. Oh, mashallah, I got a new iPod. I got a new car, I got a new house, and you want these things, you work towards, you work hard. But all these things go, every last one of them, even your house, your car, everything goes, your children, your wife, everything goes. But paradise is the one thing that Allah promises you will stay. So work towards that. كَانَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ وَعْدًا مَسْئُولًا. This is a promise that Allah will definitely fulfill. وَيَوْمَ يَحْشُرُهُمْ وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَقُولُ أَأَنْتُمْ أَضْلَلْتُمْ عِبَادِي هَؤُلَاءِ أَمْ هُمْ ضَلُّوا السَّبِيلِ. That's a whole idea. This particular part now, Allah is now turning the conversation away from Jannah, back to the Kuffar. Oh sorry, not to Kuffar. It's towards Kuffar, but not talking to them, but in reference to them. Allah is saying now, on the day when they'll be resurrected, the idols, the people they used to worship besides Allah, the Krishnas and the Shivas and the Sai Baba, and well, not Sai Baba, but like Isa, Jesus, and Uzair and others, they will ask, Allah will ask these things. When Allah resurrects the disbelievers and the things they used to worship, Allah will say, did you misguide these people, or did they just become, or they misguided themselves? And they will make bara'ah. They will say, no. They worship me, but it's nothing to do with me, especially Isa. In the end of Surah Ma'idah, Jesus mentions, Allah asked Jesus, did you say to your people, worship me and your mother besides Allah, as in Maryam, Mary? And he said, no. It was not for me to say something like that. If I had said something like that, you would definitely know about it. You know what's inside my soul. I don't know what's inside you. If you're nafsik. So Isa, in the end of Surah Ma'idah, made bara'ah. Said, no. That's what the Christians do when they call upon me and they worship me. I never called them to do that. And Allah is mentioning here that all of the things that they worship besides Allah, they will call them and say, did you ask them to do it? And they said, no. They did their own thing. And we have no say, or no, if we would not have no, how can I say it in English? no sultan, no ability or no authority, that's the word. We have no authority or ability to go and worship others. So how can we ask others to worship us? And that's something against the mushrikeen. Those who are worshipping you and you thinking will help you in the hereafter, they say, no, don't, nothing to do with you. I didn't say to do it. Even Iblis, even the devil will say himself, every time you fall into sin, say, no, I didn't make you do it. I told you and you listened, it's nothing to do with me. Which brings back to the issue as one of the very important points that some Christians might have. I know some of my relatives have it. When they might say, oh, the devil made me do it. Or the devil did this, or the devil did that. No. Your actions, you will be responsible for your own actions. All you need to remember, as Allah tells us many times, that the devil, Iblis, is a deceiver. Deceives you. Just like he deceived Adam alayhi salam. He said to Adam, if you eat this apple, you will live forever, and so forth, and so on and so forth. And he believed him, and he made a mistake, and he ate the apple. And that's the same thing with every sin. Iblis, the devil, deceives you. Every single criminal is deceived. Every single, they're deceived. If you rob this person, if you do this crime, if you kill this person, your life will be better. You'll have more money. You'll have more respect. Deception. All you'll have is punishment or retribution. People come out for revenge, or people will, or maybe you will go to jail or something. But it's just all deception. It's all deception, and everything around that is deception. Anyway. And they'll say, وَلَكِمْ مَتَّعْتَهُمْ وَآبَاءَهُمْ حَتَّى نَسُوا الذِّكْرَ وَكَانُوا قَوْمًا بُورًا. And they would try to, and they would justify what happened to them. How did they become misguided? What happened was that they and their forefathers forgot the remembrance. نَسُوا الذِّكْرَ. Allah sent to them a reminder, a prophet saying to them, worship Allah, and they forgot about the message. They forgot about what their prophet said to them. And they indulged in idle speech. They indulged in sins, and resulted in their shirk, and they became those who were destroyed. فَقَدْ كَذَّبُوكُمْ بِمَا تَقُولُونَ فَمَا تَسْتَطِيعُونَ صَرَفًا وَلَا نَصْرًا. So now that the conversation is directed towards the kuffar, the mushrikeen. Look, these people have disassociated themselves from you and what you want and your worship. So that you won't be able now, on this day, to divert or avert the punishment that's coming for you. وَمَنْ يَظْلِمْ مِنْكُمْ نُذِقْهُ عَذَابًا كَبِيرًا. And whoever from amongst you oppresses, as in himself, in idolatry, then we will make him taste a big punishment. But obviously the kuffar, they are taken off by their arrogance. Some of the kuffar are taken off by arrogance.
وقال الذين لا يرجون لقاءنا لولا أنزل علينا الملائكة أو نرى ربنا.
Same thing again. They repeated the same argument. As in, and those who don't believe in the hereafter, they will say, if only there was an angel that comes to us, or we can see Allah ourselves, then we'll believe. If we see Allah, then we'll believe.
لقد استكبروا في أنفسهم وعتوا عتوا كبيرا.
As in, they have been overcome and taken over by arrogance, which has led them to disbelieve the clear message.
يَوْمَ يَرَوْنَ الْمَلَائِكَةَ لَا بُشْرَى الْيَوْمَ يَا بُشْرَى يَوْمَ إِذِ لِلْمُجْرِمِينَ وَيَقُولُونَ حِجْرًا مَحْجُورًا.
As in the day that they'll see the angels, and the days of the commission this ayat, and days on the last day they'll see the angels, and the angels say, there's no good news for you. The angels, they will say, there's no good news for you, and you have been forbidden from any type of bashara, any good news being given to you.
وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا.
And that's a very important point to stop at. And Allah will make their good deeds, disbelievers, those who die upon disbelief. And remember, all that I'm talking about here, about disbelievers, this is in reference to those disbelievers who die upon disbelief. Because as you all know, even me, myself, I was born into a Christian family. I was raised a Christian. So I was previously a disbeliever. But hey, before I became, hopefully, inshallah, Allah could make me and all the rest of you die in Muslim. But I became accepted Islam. So this all references here, regards to what happens to disbelieving hereafter. That's referring to those who die upon kufr. And Allah say, all the actions that they did in this life, be it any good, Allah will make it as if it was ashes that blown away in the wind. As if it was nothing. They'll not have anything. Any reward from that in that case. And I think we will stop here, inshallah. we have to do the adhan.